Oh, les menteurs. Les menteurs, les menteurs. Les menteurs. Hey, hey, coucou, bonjour, welcome, welcome back to my channel. My name is Cyril. I used to be a stem cell researcher for quite some time, and this is why I can tell you about the science behind skincare ingredients. So, today's video is going to be a little bit different because I'm basically going to tell you what are like the sort of marketing tricks to basically trick you, to lie to you sort of. I don't necessarily think that all those brands really do it on purpose, because I do get that some of the marketing people, they are just not science-based, obviously, so they are not like super aware that they are sort of lying to you. But I do think that when you are a consumer and you are like, okay, I do need to incorporate, for example, this ingredient or this stuff, or I may be sensitive to perfume or etc. etc., that you have the right to have proper information, and this is the responsibility of the brand to provide you with accurate information, as simple as that. Also, I do think that it is important to know, because when you are decided to put your money into a brand, this is your personal decision, obviously. But I think it's important to know that, okay, I just give my money to this brand because I love the product. I don't know. I love the texture. I love the smell. It makes me feel good. But I know that I pay for the marketing. I know that I pay mostly for the packaging and etc., which is fine. Of course, this is not necessarily what I tend to gravitate to, but at least you know, in a way. The only thing is that when brands are like very shitty, I'm thinking about Drunk Elephant. I don't know how they are like right now, but I know that the social team is like a nightmare. I have seen some of the comments that they delete and etc. I mean, they are basically rude to consumers, especially consumers that are telling them, oh, I had a reaction with your product and etc. And they are like, oh no, this is not possible and so on. Of course it is. Of course it is. Also, all those brands that are basically using the marketing of fear. I will have a future video about this to make you scared about certain ingredients, certain chemical people. Remember, everything is a chemical, even water. So don't be worried about it. But you may be reactive to one ingredient, and you need to know which one. Okay, so the first thing that I see probably quite a lot, especially recently, maybe it's because I'm looking at it, I don't know, is when a brand promotes an ingredient and I look at the list of ingredients and, well, this ingredient is not there, and I'm like, what the hell? This is especially relevant for actives, because when you are willing to introduce an active in your routine, you want the active to work, and some especially derivative may not work as well as the real stuff. This is as simple as that. So let's start with vitamin C. I've just done a live with Bonnie Garner. It is in French, but we have talked a lot about vitamin C. What I always tell you about vitamin C, and comment down below if you want me to do another video about vitamin C. I can always talk about vitamin C. Vitamin C, the form of vitamin C is L-ascorbic acid, and that's it. The rest is not vitamin C. This is derivatives of vitamin C. This is very, very important, because remember something. When you look at what vitamin C can do on your skin, it can brighten your skin, it can help to fade out hyperpigmentation, it can also brighten the overall skin tone, so you have a more even tone. I'm not telling you that it's going to make you white, of course no, of course not. But all of this, you can have the exact same results you using like a good AHA, a good 10% AHA, you will have exactly the same results. The true power of vitamin C is the antioxidant ability of vitamin C when well formulated. High Geek & Gorgeous and C Glow, high C15 from Polite Shot, that is more expensive, but this is still a good one. The rest of derivatives, they have some of the properties, for example, to tackle hyperpigmentation. Some of them, they are working, probably less potent than L-ascorbic acid, even though we don't have like proper comparisons between the one. But for the antioxidant properties, I'm like, I don't know. I really don't know. And this is a big issue, because there are a ton of products on the market where you have vitamin C, and when you buy it, you say, oh, I have bought myself like a good vitamin C serum, or a good vitamin C cream or whatever. And when I look at the ingredient, there is no vitamin C. This is something that I really, really dislike. So the first example is from the French brand SVR, the Hydra Acid C20, for example. You have vitamin C on the package, but there is no vitamin C. This is one derivative of vitamin C, which is not bad. This is the ascorbyl tetraisopalmitate. Another example that is very, very famous, especially online, is the Ole Erickson, the Banana Bright Eye. The first time I looked at the formula was like, not really. So again, when you look at the formula, there is no vitamin C. There is the tetraexyldecyl ascorbate. And there is also another derivative, which is the ethylate form of vitamin C. So does it mean that it's necessarily bad? No, but you are not paying for vitamin C. This is what I'm telling you. You may have the brightening effect, even though in this cream, I don't have the concentration, which I don't like. Because for those of you who are suffering from hyperpigmentation on the eye, especially for derivatives, you will need a high concentration and certainly not like a smidget in the cream. Here again, you don't know. By the way, in this formula, it is not that bad, but you have two essential oils also, which I'm not a really big fan of, especially for around the eyes. I'm like, nah. So be careful with this. Be very, very careful about vitamin C and derivatives. It's very important to know the concentration, because you want to pay for something that is efficient, or even though you have results, maybe you will have even more results with a proper formula with the correct concentration. For this derivative, so the tetraisopalmitate form, you need around 20%. So you have the one from The Ordinary, for example, that is excellent. Anyway, now another example, retinol. And when I saw this, I just rolled my eyes. I was like, oh no, boy, no, no. This is the new one from COSRX. So the name is the Real Fit Retinol Serum. They have put the name retinol. It does not contain retinol. It is retinal palmitate, which is an ester of retinol. And I'm like, we have a ton of study with retinol. We basically have not much about retinal palmitate. We also know that it is pretty weak, not very efficient. So I'm like, no. And also for the price, I mean, go and buy a proper retinol. If you're really on a budget, go with the one from The Ordinary. But again, so shady. This is basically a lie. You are not paying for retinol. You are paying for an ester. Same thing with the vitamin C. You are not paying for vitamin C. You are paying for derivatives. And I really, really dislike this. Another example that is... Hi, neighbor. Another example is a product from REN. This is the Bio Retinoid Anti-Wrinkle Concentrate Oil. I mean, when you are reading this name, this is bio, so it means that it is natural, that it is good. Not really. It has essential oils also. Not a clever idea with a retinol. Oh, but there is no retinol. There is not even a retinoid. There is bakuchiol. Bakuchiol is not a retinoid. It does have some of the properties of retinol in terms of smoothing the wrinkle, for example. But we are not sure that it works at all like a retinol. But in terms just of molecular configuration, it is not the same. It's not the same beast. This is such a big lie. I'm like, no. No. Also, again, in this product, be very careful about that. We do not know the concentration of bakuchiol. It has to be around 2%, and it has to be used in the morning and in the evening to have sort of similar effect of compared to retinol. But it's only going to be like to smooth the skin tone, to fade out some of the hyperpigmentation and etc. For the dermis, we do not know. Another thing that is about youth to the people that I also really don't like, you have the same thing with the Brand Glow recipe. It is sort of mixed like, oh, we are using fruits or superfood, so because it is good to eat them, it is of course good for the skin. This also, it's just like, no, you basically have no study, for example, about the kale. You know, they have this kale cream that I've reviewed, the Superfood Hair Whip Moisture Cream, that also contains perfume. They call it natural perfume, as if natural perfume means better perfume. It is not. This is the same if you're allergic to it, whether it is natural or not. This is the same. This being said, like essential oils, for example, there are more people allergic to essential oils derivatives and essential oils than synthetic perfume. So again, it is not a gauge of no irritation anywhere. So this one contains kale and spinach. I mean, it makes no sense. Absolutely no sense. Same thing with Glow Recipe, with the banana, the avocado, and etc. I'm like, oh boy, no. Really, I don't like this, because it makes you think that because you eat something that is healthy for you, it will be healthy for the skin. But when you eat something, there are a lot of amount of natural
process, because this is processed food in reality. What happens in your stomach and etc., it is going to degrade all of this. And also all the cells in the epidermis of your gut, your stomach and etc., they are coated with a sort of mucus, which is like a sort of gel that also protect them and etc. So something that is maybe not irritating when you eat it can be very also irritating on top of the skin. And also we don't know. So I don't like this when they promote like kale and whatever, and I'm like, no, they do promote hyaluronic acid, rightly so, because we know that it is efficient. By the way, this one is barely hydrating. I really don't like the moisturizer from used to the people. Okay, the last thing, medical grade, and I'm going to give you the example of Zoe skincare. This is a non-regulated term. So basically, when you are paying for those very usually expensive skincare, you are absolutely not guaranteed that they will be better than another one. So let's have a look to one, which is the Zoe Skin Health Radical Night Repair. Very expensive one. It contains 1% retinol. So this is per se medical grade. When you look at the formula, the beginning, I'm like, okay, why not? They use oleosum from sweet almond. I'm pretty sure that they are using a manufacturer, a supplier basically from South Korea. But anyway, so they use retinol, perfectly fine. No problem with this. But then you have an extra from Zantoxylum, which is a kind of pepper that is not necessarily the best. And then at the end, you have citral and limonene plus fragrance. I'm like, how come? You are paying medical grade. Usually with medical grade, you do have active ingredients that are quite potent at high concentration to really impact the look of your skin. So the last thing that you want to do is to introduce some very irritating ingredients like citral, for example. I'm like, hell no. And I know for some people who are using Zoe, some other people had like massive reaction to it because of those damn ingredients. So you are not paying for more here. You are paying for something that may be more irritating than something else. You are looking for a good 1% retinol that is a little bit pricey, but less than that. I mean, poor choice. 1% retinol, lovely, lovely. So basically, that's it for today. I hope you did like this video. If you did, well, you know what to do. Give it a thumbs up. Also, don't forget to comment down below. If you are new, consider to subscribe. Ring the bell. You can also follow me on my two Instagram accounts, one in English and one in French. I also have a YouTube channel in French. Thank you so much for your precious time, for always being here, for always being so supportive, and thank you so much. And I will see you next time. Au revoir.